as I saw Love for Giggles CD, and it's about the time I went down to the pub down the road here and was introduced to a drink called a Slippery Nipple by a guy called Tom Moffat. Sorry, Tom. Now, Slippery Nipple is a cocktail of Zambuca with Baileys in it. And you down it in a winner, and it's a very, very nice drink, I have to say. There is a side effect in that it does blow your head right off your shoulders after you've had a couple. But that's all part of the fun. Now, because Zambuca's involved in it, things got a wee bit out of hand, and I ended up burning all the hair off the backs of both my hands, which wasn't very nice. So this is a true story of what happened that night. It's called The Night of the Fiery Mitts at the One Lock Head Inn. I thank you. It was 4 o'clock in the morning when I came to on the floor, wondering how on earth I got there, what I'd done the night before. I was lying in the kitchen in that shivery drunken state, so I peeled my cheek off the lino and I tried to sit up straight. Once my head stopped spinning and the heavy breathing stopped, I uncrossed my eyes and tried my best to focus on the wall. Then a blinding light exploded and she was towering on my head. With a look that dripped disgust, her eyes said all that needed said. I was not a very pretty sight, I really must admit. Saliva caked my cheeks and dribbles dripping from my lip. My shirt was stained with alcohol and stuffed up to my clothes. The remnants of some fresh regurgitation, I suppose. I thought I'd get some sympathy with a made-up tale of woe. When I put my brain in gear, I found my mouth refused to go. It was an incoherent ramble, cause the words just weren't there. But she just said, shut up and tell me why you smell a burning hair. Well, I thought, oh no, but I said, ah yes, as I had become aware of a rather pungent, singy smell pollute the kitchen air. And the smell brought back the memory of what was left of it, of Moffat's slippery nipples and the night of the fiery mitts. It was a nice wee crowd for a Sunday night, a civilised soiree. James the barman poured the booze, we were quiet and well behaved. But also there, parked at the bar in his understated way, was a Moffat sitting smiling, mischief pouring from his face. He said, I found a drink you'll like, have I go with one of these? It's Zambuca topped with Baileys, it slips down your throat a treat. And as you're off tomorrow, give here's a chance you cannot miss. In fact, line up those slippery nipples, James, we're going to get them pissed. And pissed I got, believe me, I could hardly say my name. And a drink called Cheeky Pimpto, well, it got hammered just the same. We were talking drunken drivel, which of course we thought was wit. And then occurred the incident that led to the fiery mitts. Now a slippery nipple's wonderful, it really must be said. But when James ran out of Baileys, it was Zambuca straight instead. I was far too drunk to notice, but even so it seemed alright. But no one ever said, they said, the bloody stuff alight. I raised the glass to down it and I won her like a man. Unaware that I was holding an inferno in my hand, I turned around to answer someone calling out my name. When some fire jumped out the glass and whoosh, my hand went up in flames. Well, I shrieked and moved that glass aflame from my left hand to my right. And to douse my fiery burning mitts, I flapped in air and fright. But this just shoot the other hand and you've guessed it, I can tell. Some stuff spilled out the glass and my right hand went up as well. Well, quick as a flash, I placed that glass of hellfire on the bar. And I stood and stared at my burning mitts. Well, you know how slow drunks are. And a thought came slowly to me, why are your hands now spouting flame? Followed quickly by, it's only cause you're drunk you feel no pain. Panic, said another thought, and get these flames put it out. So I raised my arms in the air and started flapping them about. With my burning hands above my head, I was shrieking in alarm, like a blazing ballerina with no grace or style or charm. Well, the fire went out and my hands came down, I was glad to be alive. But my hands were balled up to the wrist, not a follicle survived. My skin was like a burned out stretch of wasteland, warm and bare, where western smoke goes silently from black and crispy hair. Well, it all goes blank from there on, and I remember nothing more. Till I woke up in the morning with my face stuck to the floor, my peach pit hanging over me, awaiting a reply. Better tell the truth, I thought, so I gave up trying to lie. I went to the pub for one wee drink, I groveled through the pain. But I met a big bad man down there and he led poor me astray. It seems that I got pissed, dear heart, and my hands were all aflame. But it wasn't me, it was Moffat slip